your first acting class is not going to teach you how to cry. We have to build up to that. So we're first, because this is what most people want to do, is they want to pick up a script and just start putting in either working off keywords or putting in just notes of how they should say it. And even Amy said it in the workshop yesterday. It's not, I quoted it, but it's not about how you're going to say it. It's about how you're going to live it, right? Mm. So it's, but in order to do that, we've got to, first of all, figure out how to even connect and find our point of view in things. So the first stages of our class, if you jump into a class, it's literally going to be teaching you to be present with your partner. That's it right now. And then we'll teach you to kind of find a point of view about what's going on with this person. How do I feel about it? And how do I feel, and how do they feel about it? And then we'll jump into starting to believe in like a smaller imaginary circumstance, you know, a circumstance that's not life-threatening, something that you can relate to right now. And then we'll teach you how to emotionally prepare. And that's an ongoing process. I mean, even in the book, the Meisner book, he says it takes 5 years to perfect emotional preparation because it's a challenge. When we go through our daydreams, we're back there, and the goal is that we're really present in that daydream, and we're really feeling and touching and seeing and all of that. But I will promise and tell you, the more you do this, it becomes easier and easier. You can go back there and in 3 minutes cry. But at first, through doing emotional preparation, it's sometimes 20 minutes before you can go back there and you'll really feel the depth. Sometimes we prepare back there, and I know a lot of my students do this, and they're like, Jessica, I wish you would have called me out 15 minutes ago. I had it. And I said, you didn't have it. That was a surface level preparation. You need to go deeper right now. So push through and trust and stay in that daydream. But this isn't something that just happens. A lot of actors think, oh, I can cry on demand. Let me put eye drops. You know, you feel it when someone's actually crying and feeling. And it's not always even about crying. It's about having the behavior. You don't have to have all these tears a lot of times. You can have the heaviness too.
Yes.
But you have to be able to go there to do that.
Yeah, crying is a result.
Right? Correct.
Yeah. And you have to go there again and again and again and again, depending on the director.
Yeah, and that's the other thing I say. You can, in class, maybe come in 2 times and feel that fullness. You go on set, it's going to be much more difficult. So we need to consistently do it in class.
Because
it's
based in the preparation.
Yes.
So if you get a hit on a script right away and you start to cry right away, that's actually bad. Because you don't know, because you'll be like, oh, I could cry now. All right, I got that set.
Yeah, I got that set.
Because I cried when I picked up the script.
Yeah.
But the truth of the matter is, it was a superficial attack on it.
Yep.
You didn't really find where it was in a deep connected way. Mm-hmm. So you're not going to be able to repeat it over and over and over again.
Yeah.
So it's actually the worst thing that could happen is if you get an initial.
And also, if you don't have a deep technique to get there, you're going to be thrown off by the reader, thrown off by other things.
Yep, the lights.
Some direction from the director.
Yep. Right? Oh, redirection, rewriting, something else is going to throw you off. You have to have technique.
Yep.